Downers Grove South High School. My mother signed me up for my first class the summer of 73, oil painting. This was the summer before my freshman year. I was shy, awkward, skinny little thing, and so quiet. I was a dork. His name was Mr. Modulewski. He said we could call him Mr. Mod. He was, in fact, very mod and very cool. And hey, it was the 70s. I remember we listened to hours and hours of his Barry Manilow collection while we learned to paint. He said we would learn to love it. One time I was near his desk, and I saw a drawing he was working on. He could see I was amazed. He leaned back and said, "Damn, I'm good." Wow. I was taken back, shocked really. He looked me right in the eye with all seriousness and said, "You know, you have to believe you're great if you ever want to be great." And I believed him. On the other hand, I wasn't comfortable with that idea for myself. But it grew on me, and my expectations of myself grew. So did my dreams. He involved us all in community projects. In the summer of 76, it was a bicentennial mural on Main Street. He made us work in pairs on each figure. I wanted to paint Shirley Temple by myself. Cindy didn't seem to mind if I came back on the weekend and painted over her baby. But Mr. Mond was furious. He didn't care to hear all my explanations. It was just plain wrong. And maybe Cindy was just too nice to say anything. Jeez, I was a brat. One time he caught me ditching and hanging out in class when he was at lunch. And boy, did he let me have it. Don't you know you have to get good grades in all your classes if you want to go to college? I hadn't even thought about college. Mr. Mod was always busy entering our art in all kinds of local and national contests. He was so excited to tell me I won this contest. That was the good news. But my drawing automatically became the property of Illinois Bell. That was the deal. When he told me that, I cried. To me, it was like I lost my best friend. I could tell he felt bad. I felt horrible. Wasn't long before I forgot about all that. Good news. I had a full ride, 4-year scholarship. 2 years later, I dropped out. Then I got a second chance. I applied for another scholarship. Mr. Mod wrote a letter of recommendation for me. Wow. He still believed in me more than I believed in myself. I got the scholarship. I finally graduated in 87. After graduation, I came back to visit Mr. Mod. We talked for a while and went back to his office. He reached behind the door and pulled out my old drawing. Somehow, he had managed to get it back from Illinois Bell. I'd forgotten all about it a long time ago. He didn't. And this is just one story, and there are so many stories like mine. We know we've grown up when we begin to appreciate, to recognize, especially teachers. It's a thankless job, really. Like raising children at times, or so it seems. With teachers, I guess, because we think it goes without saying. But it's worth saying. Their voices are imprinted in our minds, forever reminding us who we are, what our dreams are, and to believe. Looking back, Mr. Mod was so right about just about everything. But I must admit, I never grew to love Barry Manilow. but I did fall in love with art.
But how do you thank someone who has taken you from crayons to perfume?